Hello YouTubers, and welcome for this T4D or Tipple Thought for the Day. Right, so I thought we'd jump in straight to the kind of topic of this T4D, and that is the next multimeter giveaway. Now you'll know the Mastech MS8218 caused a fair bit of controversy when I did the review, but nonetheless, it's a nice high resolution multimeter and good accuracy. It's also got PC data logging. So this will be the giveaway for the end of November. I'm going to post a link down below to the entry on the forum. There's a few questions and an upload of a photograph or two which you need to do to actually enter for this. So if you go there, there'll be a draw for this at the end of November. And we're going to have another multimeter giveaway in December as well. So certainly there's a fair bit of opportunity if you jump in and start entering for these on the forum. Then there's another video series I actually plan to start. As I said, I generally speaking don't do teardowns or what have you because it's not an area of expertise for me, and it hasn't been a huge interest for me either. But there are a few items, and this Solar Focus Amazon Kindle case is one that I want to take a closer look at inside because I want to make comparisons with the project that I'm working on. So what I plan to do, I've kind of carefully felt I can feel there are some screws under here. I'm going to start a series called something like Take a Look Inside. And if there are items which I'm really intrigued to have a look inside, just to see how they're put together or how they, perhaps how they work. And in particular, this device, I'd like to see how it works. So I'm going to take it apart. I'm going to want to take measurements of the solar panel to see how well it works, what it puts into the battery. I'm going to start that series soon, and this will be the first item that I take apart so we can have a look at inside. Then another project is the electronic DC load. My second case for it has arrived. So this was the one which I ordered so that I have enough space on the front to place the panel meter and my two big potentiometers. But I've had another kind offer, and I'll put something to you. A very good viewer based in Canada, first of all, said that he would be quite happy to assist me with a design of a custom case for this. And then he made the suggestion, and it's something which has been brought up before, is to actually manufacture my own PCB. Now, as a side from this, again, there's someone who's also John, who's posted his project on my forum. And again, I'll put a link to that below, and he's actually thinking of manufacturing his own PCB, so that'll be interesting to follow on the forum. But I must say, I'm keen to give that a bash myself. However, it's going to prolong the kind of end result when I actually get to finish this electronic DC load. So give me an idea below, post a comment. I plan to make at least another two of these with various differences to the first one. So if you're keen to see this one finished, then I'll hold off on the whole customized case and PCB for now, and I'll save that for the second one. So let me know whether you want me to do it for this one or save it for the second one. Then what also happened was I went shooting. I've got a slip saying that I had something at customs which I had to go and pay for. I was dearly hoping it was going to be the UT61E. But it wasn't, alas, it was a panel meter that I bought on eBay, where obviously the guys thought they were doing me a favor by putting a $5 value on it when I paid, I think, $19. And of course, then customs queries it, and then I have to do about a 25K round trip to go and get them. But I've got a few panel meters coming, and those will be other choices and options for the electronic DC load. So look out for that, and then I say, Frankie posted some interesting information. He got a UT61E, and he found that the accuracy wasn't quite there. And another good viewer also has sent me some messages stating the same thing. So that's certainly something I'm going to have a look at when my Unity UT61E arrives to see whether there's an issue with the accuracy and the build quality of it. So look out for that. Okay, then another thing I wanted to draw your attention to was Todd Harrison of toddfun.com. I did post a link to this in my forum. He managed to, lucky fish. Shouldn't say lucky fish. He obviously kept an eye open, and he jumped in, and had a great find. He came across a Fluke 289, so the slightly older brother of my 287, or I shouldn't say older, better brother of my 287. He came across that in a combo kit with the software and everything, and he paid $200 and something for it, and it had only been used a couple of times. So I'm going to post a link to his video of that. I'll either annotate it here or put it below. He also demonstrated, he showed the accuracy on his voltage standards DMMCheck Plus. And Doug has said, mine is in the post on the way to me, so as soon as I receive that, I'll certainly do a review of that. But Todd says he's also going to post a review on his. So certainly go and watch Todd's channel. He does some great reviews, and he also plans to do a full review of his 289. And he was asking people whether they want to do that or not. So certainly post a comment there, and I'm sure you'll spur Todd on to do a review of that meter. He's going to do a side-by-side against his Fluke 289 versus his Fluke 87. Okay, and what I want to also bring to your attention, and again, it's thanks very much to you guys. I've now cracked the 4,000 subscriber mark. We're in fact approaching 4,200. I'm pretty sure during the course of November, I'll be at 5,000. And by the end of November, I'm at about 850,000, close to 850,000 views. I'll crack a million views. And again, in the greater scheme of things, those are small numbers for a channel, but certainly not bad, and I certainly didn't think I would be hitting those numbers by this point in time. So things are getting to the point literally when the channel is actually going to sustain me, which is a really big relief, because it means it's not something I'll have to pack in. I certainly don't want to pack it in because I really enjoy doing this, but it's getting to the point where it is going to sustain me. So I thank you all very much for that. And again, my Amazon store has been used very well. And I say, if you do want to find an easy way to support me without handing over cash where you get nothing back for it, certainly have a look at the link to my Amazon store below. There's loads of electronic bits and pieces on there. And also, you can, even if you go onto Amazon through the link and do a search for anything, I gain a small commission for anything that's purchased through my link. So again, I thank you very much. And with all these things happening, I know there's been a delay in the Arduino and electronics tutorials, and barring the video which I'm busy doing for Victron Energy, the next thing I work on will be the Arduino tutorial. So look out for that being posted soon. So again, I thank you very much, and I'll catch you soon for the next video. Cheers.